Hello everyone, welcome back to this video on digital communication. In this video, I am going to talk about the orthogonal frequency division multiple access, or OFDM. So if I talk about OFDM, it's the advanced form of FDMA. I have already covered FDMA in one of my previous video. So I recommend you to watch that first because it's an advanced form of FDMA, so I may be referring it. So you should know FDMA first. So if I talk about OFDM now, OFDMA is used in various 4G applications. So it is used in 4G technologies like LTE. LTE is long-term evolution, or it is used in LTE Advanced or WiMAX. WiMAX is worldwide interoperability from microwave access. So first I'll talk about the applications of orthogonal frequency division multiple access. So it is used in fourth generation wireless communication like LTE long term evolution. After that it is used in LTE Advanced, and after that it is used in WiMAX. So it is used in LTE, LTE Advanced and WiMAX. So now if I talk about the data rate, so the data rate in OFDM is very high. So this is the beauty of OFDM. So if I talk about OFDM, its data rate is really high when I compare to the data rate of FDMA. So when I talk about FDMA, it is used in 1G communication. I hope you understand how fast is 4G communication with respect to 1G communication, and why it is fast? Because of large bandwidth. The bandwidth available is 10 megahertz. So if I talk about the delay time would be 1 upon 10 megahertz, which would be equal to 0.1 microsecond. So now the generally available delay time, which is TD dash, is nearly equal to 2 to 3 microsecond. So I hope you can see the delay time here is really less when I compare to the generally available delay time. So I hope now you can see the data rate is really high. So why it is really high? I have large bandwidth. Bandwidth is nearly 10 megahertz. So when I have large frequency bandwidth available with me, then the data can travel really fast. If the bandwidth availability would be less, then data can't travel fast. So here the bandwidth availability is high, because of which the data transmission rate is really high. So this is the beauty of OFDM. So now if I talk about the limitations of previously existing technologies, so the first limitation is multipath fading. So let's suppose this is my receiver and this is my transmitter. So I am making, this is my transmitter, this is my receiver, and this is a building. So now what would happen? A signal can go straight from the receiver, from the transmitter to the receiver, and another signal can go to the building, reflect from the building, and then receive to the receiver. So now if this is the frequency band for first symbol and this is the frequency band for second symbol. So now I hope you can see this signal would be received faster and this signal would be received after a delay. So this is my second signal. So this is the probability of error. So this is the error which is occurring. And this is the delayed signal. And here this is my delayed signal. So the delayed signal is represented by red and the direct signal is represented by black. So now when delayed signal is superimposed on the second symbol, so I hope you can see this is my first symbol only. The first symbol is superimposing on the second symbol and this is causing the error in the second symbol. So this is causing the inter-symbol interference. So the second limitation would be inter-symbol interference. So if the first frequency band superimposes on the second frequency band, so this is called the inter-symbol interference. And due to this, what would happen? Crosstalk would be there. So now I can say due to multipath fading, crosstalk would be present. And the second limitation was inter-symbol interference. So if I talk about the third limitation, so the third limitation is frequency selective fading. If I talk about the channel, in the channel a lot of fading would be happening because the channel is mostly air. So the channel is air which is not a dedicated channel like wire. If I talk about wire, the errors or the fading in the wire would be very less. But when I talk about the wireless communication, so that time fading would be really high. So now this fading can be removed using, so the channel equalization techniques are used to reduce the frequency selective fading. So now if I talk about the OFDM, so OFDM is the advanced form of FDMA. So if I talk about FDMA, so if these are my users, so now what I do, I use different carriers at different frequencies for different users. So this is my user 1, this is user 2, and this is user 3, and this is F0, this is F1, this is F2. So this is frequency. So now I'll combine them and I'll send them. So now at F0, I'll superimpose the carrier F0 with user 1. So this F0 carrier is superimposed with user 1. So now user 1 is going dedicatedly with the help of frequency F0. So now, you can see here we have different frequencies for different users. Plus I have this difference of user 1 and user 2 frequency band, which is called guard band. So guard band is used to reduce this multipath fading or ISI. So if I have this first symbol and this second symbol with the guard band, and if delay would be happening, so let's suppose it came with the delay, so this signal would be present here. So now this guard band protects my signals from ISI. So now let's suppose further delay would be happening, so this further delay is represented using this, and again it is saved from ISI. So there is a need of presence of guard band in frequency division multiple access. But now the trick in OFDM is we don't need guard band because of this bandwidth efficiency would be really high. So if I talk about OFDM, in OFDM I have orthogonal carriers. So now these carriers are orthogonal in nature. So if I talk about the Fourier transform of rectangular pulse would be the sync pulse. So this is rectangular, this is sync F. So the Fourier transform of rect is sync F, we all know that. So now if I talk about the orthogonal carriers, so these are distributed 15 kilohertz frequency apart. So if I have, so let's take, so these are my various carriers, and the difference between their frequency is 15 kilohertz. So this is 15, this is 15. So from here I can say the symbol duration would be 1 upon 15 kilohertz, which would be 66.67 or 66.7 microsecond. This is my symbol duration. So it is fixed for OFDM. So now if I talk about the orthogonal carriers, so the orthogonal carriers are represented like this. So you can see the first null is at the second peak. So if I draw the second orthogonal carrier, so it is like this. So if I draw the third orthogonal carrier, it is like this. So you can see if I have the peak of second carrier. So this is FC2, this is FC1, this is FC3. So the peak of second carrier is at the null of first carrier. Similarly, the peak of third carrier is at the null of first carrier. So this is called the orthogonality property, and I don't need any guard band. So you can see there is no guard band. So because of which it has better frequency efficiency. So I hope you understood what is OFDM and how I can generate OFDM with the help of orthogonal carriers. So if you still have any doubt, you can put your doubt in the comment box and I'll try to resolve it as soon as possible. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and push the like button. Thank you.